One key concept that you need to learn when you are dealing with large data sets in Excel is how to create data types. What do I mean by this? Basically, if you see this database, which is not that big, but if you go on the right side, you can see that I have 36 columns. And 36 columns, it becomes hard to go. For example, you are looking for one type of information. Every time you have to toggle to find the right column. So this is not very efficient. This data type concept means that I'm going to aggregate some data or some columns into one column. Let me show you how to do this and you'll understand better. So first of all, I'm going to transform this into an Excel table. So I'll do insert, table. My table has headers, okay. And then I can call it HRDB. Enter. The second thing I'm going to do is go to Power Query. So we have data and this get and transform data tab. If you don't see it, it means your Excel version is before 2016, but you have a free add-in called Power Query and you can use it. So I'm just going to do this from table range. So now Power Query has loaded all my columns. What I'm going to do is create a data type. So we go to transform to the end structured column, and then we have create data type. We get a window. I'm going to click on advanced, move the window a little bit, and we need to give a name to our first data type. So the first thing I'm going to look for is my demographic information. So 01 demographics. And then we need a display column. We're going to come back to this in a bit. But let me search for the columns that I want that are related to demographic. So some of them is just my liking. Obviously, it doesn't mean that this is the right way to group them, but I just want to illustrate the concept. So I'm going to take the employee ID. I press Control, keep Control pressed. Then I'm going to select the columns that I want. So married, gender. Then we can do state, zip, date of birth, sex, marital description, citizen description, Hispanic, Latino, race. And if you go down, I think that's it. You can also take the LinkedIn profile. And then we click on add. So we have all of them here. Now, if we want to, we can also click on one and make it go up. So that's an example. You can do anything, you can order them the way you like. And here, it's the column that will represent this data set. So I'm going to keep the employee name, but I can choose any of the columns that I've added here. So we're going to say OK. And if you browse through the data, you're going to see that at the end, I have a new column that is called 01 demographic that has the name of the person. And if you click here, you can see all the columns that I've put under this. So this is my first data type. Let's make another one for employment, for example. So we go to transform, structured, create data type, 02 employment. So here I'm gonna group everything under employment. So I don't want demographic. I'm gonna remove it and I can select the employment ones. Again, you can press Control, and you can check salary, position, for example, date of hire, termination. We add them. And here I want to put the position as my front column. I'm going to click on OK. And we're going to get a second one, which is employment. As you can see here with the position in front. The third one, it's going to be quick so I don't bore you. We're going to do transform. Create data type, performance, and happiness. We go to advanced. We just select everything except the employment and the demographic. And we're going to put performance score as a display column. We say OK. We're going to move demographic in front. And we go close and load. You can see here that I have transformed my database into three columns, and it's easy to see them. The good thing is that if you click on this symbol that is next to the name, for example, or the position or the performance, you're gonna get a card. And in this card, you're gonna get all the information that you have aggregated, which is a cool way to see something. So for example, if I want to see the demographic of this person, I can just go and scroll down and see it. The same for employment and performance. Another cool thing is that you can get access to this information very easily. So for example, if I do equal and I select this, I can do dot, and after the dot, I will get the title or the name of every column that is included into this data set. So for example, if I want to know the citizen description, I can just select it, press enter, and I can see the citizen description column. Another final hack I want to show you with this is that if I get the LinkedIn profile, for example, I select this, you can see that I cannot click on those LinkedIn profiles. So what do? I can just go here, and before that, I can use the hyperlink formula, and I can do comma, call it LinkedIn, for example, close it, and here if I click, I'm gonna get directly to his LinkedIn profile. So this is how it works for data types. As you can see, it is a very efficient way to work with big data, where you can aggregate the data into one column, and then you can access the different elements that you have in these columns, and you can do anything from applying formulas like hyperlink or doing some mathematical operations. So please let me know if you have used data types in the past, and it would be great if I can get a small like on this video and if you can subscribe to the channel.